Hi guys, it's Marco Maiolino from Tomorrow.it. Just a moment that I switch on the keynote. Okay guys, I check the audio. Okay, it's fine. Okay, this night we will do another live webinar. This time I want to change the topic. Last time we have talked about a very technical subject about prosthetic dentistry, about vertical preparations. Now I want to do something very different, something that you never see usually in courses and congresses. I see that, okay, let's see this nice feature of OBS. It's something that I've learned today to see the comments and the chat here on the left of the screen. Honestly, this night we will talk about something that you will never see in other kind of courses because we, but not just we dentists, all the medical field, we are not so much acquainted with failure. Most of cases, doctors tend to hide their failures. We have little ability to share failure. But the reality, and it is what I will show in this lecture, is that honestly, failure has been my very first reason to improve in my life. In the past, honestly, I was shy. I was hiding my failures. When some people was coming to my office in the past, I was checking for the planning in order that I have perfect patient and perfect cases. Now I don't do. So I think that we have to change our approach to failure. What I do this night is to show mine. But it is because I want you to change your approach with failures. So let's start with this lecture. I hope that you will learn something about dentistry, but honestly, I hope that I will be able to give you a small push, a small hint to change your mindset about when things goes wrong. Also because, you know, in Italy and all the Europe, the situation is quite not so nice, we can say. So this is another period of our life where we have to deal with something that is not so much nice. So let's start with this keynote. We can say life. What is life? At the end, life is so many things and something so philosophical that we have not an answer. But at the end, life is what we do. And it's very nice to understand in our life how do we spend our time. Because it's calculated that we men, not you women, of course, we men spend 3,000 hours shaving. And if you are rich, like Daniele Bordonali, you go to the barber. We spend 6 years, and I am afraid that in the next future it will be much more. We spend 6 years staying on our phone, okay? Chatting, Messenger, Facebook. What are you doing now? I never do this, but usually we spend 11 years watching TV, and usually it's trash, honestly. We spend 28,000 hours eating. We spend 26 years sleeping. But honestly, in our life, the most important time that we spend in our life, it's 100,000. It's working. So honestly, it's not just because I want to say that work is important, but it's because working is a so big part of our life that the quality of life that you have in your work, it's the quality of the life that you have. I always strived for excellence, honestly. I've tried, of course, with some ups and some downs, but it's the approach to go for excellence that changes your life in every field. Wait for a moment. I go back Okay, here. This was a famous Vince Lombardi. He was a famous trainer of football. Okay, nothing so important. But Vince was an amazing motivator for people, for their athletes, for their players. He said that the quality of our life is related to our commitment to excellence in our field of work. Doesn't matter the field. So, even if, according to our patient, in many cases, we are not so nice doctors, okay? And we are much more similar in the mind of our patient to Montgomery Burns, an ugly doctor just looking for some money. I really love what I do, and I really think that the way in which I do my work will change my life. When we talk about excellence, there is always one question. The path toward excellence is a matter of talent, of genius. Because I see, talking with colleagues, when I go to courses and congresses, that many, many persons always talk about this so-called talent, okay? About this so-called genius. I read a lot of books about this topic, honestly, and this is one of the books I prefer. This is the books from Albert Erickson, Anders Erickson. I have here. This is the Italian version for the Italian readers because the title is different. It's numero uno si diventa. Instead, in English, is completely different. The title is Secrets from the New Science of Expertise. But this book is very interesting because according to the authors, because they studied the cognitive biases in all the fields to understand how human psychology works, and they discovered that doctors exercising from 20 or 30 years were worse than doctors just specialized. They found that the mere repetition of a task every day is not related to improving or maintenance of this ability. You have to go with this concept. The simple repetition of a task every day make the doctor getting worse during the years. So most of the senior doctors work in a worse way than the younger ones. So the reality is that in the life and in the work, or you go ahead or you go back. You cannot stop at your level of your abilities. There is no a balance in the life. You have to strive to go on, to go forward, or otherwise, the law of gravity, you will go back. And that the simple time, it's not about 12 hours working, it's not enough. Experience means nothing, and practice alone is useless. So we go to the focus of today. Why? Because to improve ourselves, it's not enough to work, but you have to do what they call focused practice. And it is a sequence of small objectives in order to go to arrive to the bigger one. And focused practice need feedback, okay? And need to go over your area of confidence. Just a bit, but you have continuously to go over your skill. The problem is the feedback is what I see, is the very critical point. Because having a feedback means accept and recognizing a mistake. And we as a doctors have a culture prone not to look at mistakes. We talk always about complications with patients, especially when we talk about more important things in the hospital. We always talk about accident, but we never talk about mistakes because we are scared about them. We are scared about how other people, how other doctors will look at our service. We are scared about how we look at our service, like people with a lack of experience, a lack of ability. Another problem, we need the sequence to arrive to a goal. But which is the goal? Because it's easy to say that in our profession, the aim is the clinical success. But what are the objectives that we have to follow to arrive to the clinical success? And this is another problem. Because when I was young, I did a lot of courses following and dreaming about the so-called state of art of dentistry, about adhesive dentistry, modern dentistry, rubber dam everywhere, even on my head, thinking that this was the path to successful dentistry. But as you see, for example, in this case, this beautiful shoulder on this horizontal prep with this beautiful fiber post, look the outcome, the clinical outcome that we have, and we will see this case in details. Excuse me for this, but my barber is closed in these days, so. The problem is that nowadays, guys, if you want to send me messages, send on the, not in the private one, because I cannot answer, because I'm using the iPhone like a cam, okay? Send here on the chat, because I have the possibility to look at the comments in the chat. Okay. Unfortunately, nowadays, we live in a period where we like to show our best. Angelina Jolie and Brad Pitt. Here, this is an Italian magazine. Happy to love. We like to show these images of happiness. And this is instead the clinical outcome, we can say. Divorce for irreconcilable differences. We show just a part of our life. And in a field like dentistry, like medicine, this is really a problem. Because without recognizing our mistakes, we will never be able to go on. This is a part of a bigger lecture that I have, honestly. But I think that even with this short one, and this is not so short, however, I will drive you to the point. Because when we go to the Congress, we always see these cases. Patient with this kind of smile, aesthetic request. This was the preoperative with the milky canine, some discotomy on these central incisors, aesthetic problem, there was a bascule of the occlusal plane. And this is the follow-up after 4 years, after some lesion desiccated crowns and veneers and more gingival surgery. And this is the smile of the patient after 4 years and all. We love these cases. Another case, for example, this patient complaining about the complete lack of his teeth during smile, problem of abrasion, erosion. I did this case with a complete adhesive approach, just using only veneers, you know. This is the veneers made by my technician, Moreno Tarascio. Here, the miracle and the dream of adhesive dentistry, even on posterior area, from side to side. And this is the postoperative with the final case. In this case, now I have to say it's perfect at 5 years. We love to. We love this kind of words. We love beauty. We love to use words like aesthetic. We love happiness. And we think that this is the road to success. That success is a straightforward road, but this is not the reality. Honestly, the main lie in your life, the main lie in my life in the past, has been about my concept, my idea of success. Honestly. Because people think that success is something like this, a straightforward road. But success is much more similar to this. It's a up and down continuously. And the real ability is not an genius or talent. It's the real ability is that when you go down, to find the force and the motivation to go again up. This is another great book, if you like, is Win at Losing of Sam Wayman. I move for the title of the author. This is a very interesting book. I love all these kind of books. I love also books about habits. It's a field that I understand that it's one of the most important things to develop to have a successful life. And I don't talk about dentistry. I talk about life in 360 degrees. Failure, I have understood. At the beginning, I didn't understand. I was so sad, so hungry at the beginning. But I understood with the time that these are lessons of life. Thanks to failures, you improve your skill, you improve your knowledge. You learn also to be humble, because sometimes you do perfect cases and you have failure, and I will show you a very unlucky case. You learn the art to fall and rise again. You learn what we are. You learn to recognize nature's masterpiece. And you learn to be human. So, now, guys,
the horror show.
Let's start.
This is just the beginning.
Okay. Do you remember this film? It was a nice one. Lot of splatter, a lot of blood. Okay, guys, the first things, before we jump into the nice part that you want, because you want to see my worst, my shit, the first a question before. Shit happens after. Okay? This, for those interested, because a lot of people asked me about these photos, this real shit is first quality, pure organic countryside shit for urban chic farmers. It's something like 9 euro for all figures. Okay. However, being serious, shit happens after how much time? Because the problem is, in big cases especially, I discovered that it's not on the short term. Okay? Like when you have the start of a race like this and immediately in the crowd some accident happens. In my experience, most of the problems in complex rehabilitation happen after 5-6 years, okay? So, I think this is of paramount importance, because when you go to a speaker, to a course, and you see follow-up shorter than 5 years, in my experience, it's zero, that speaker, okay? You can speak about the complex rehab honestly, if you have done at least from 7 years. Because in my experience, at 6-7 years, all the small mistakes that you have left come back. Okay? And this is a problem also with specialists in prosthetic. You know, I am a general dentistry. Specialists in prosthetic, in a lot of cases, takes patient from other offices because they have to do the complex work, and then send the patient back to their office, losing any kind of follow-up. In these cases, you think that you are the best of the world, and you aren't. So, the key is to have long-term follow-ups. This is the reason because tonight I will share with you cases with 15 years of follow-up. Because if I show you 2, 3, and 5 years, the case is completely successful. Let's start with this case. This case is a case that now is at 13 years of follow-up. This was a patient with a worn dentition. She had this abraded teeth. And she had also a problem of a fistula on her upper lateral. This was the smile. The patient came to my office for two reasons in particular: aesthetic request and for the fistula in the area of the lateral. Okay, this was the X-ray. I was able also to do the endodontic retreatment of the lower second molar on the right. I did extraction and implants in the lower, but I didn't change the vertical dimension of occlusion. And when you deal with patient with abrasion of the incisal margin, I've learned at my expenses that this is one of the most wrong ideas that you can have. So what I did? There was this huge lesion on the lateral. I removed the cuspos. I redid the orthograde treatment. This was my idea about the treatment plan. Teeth were quite short, so my plan was to increase both on the incisal margin and on the gingival margin, doing a crown lengthening procedure. This was the plan. So I jumped with the enthusiasm of one that had experienced not so much failures in his life and thus the technical skill to do some things. I jumped doing a crown lengthening surgery, and I did again a new endodontic surgery. Okay, this is the surgical follow. This is the X-ray immediately after the surgery. The healing of the lesion was fine. The fistula after 1 week disappeared. Soft tissue were perfect. So what I did? I did the veneers from on canine lateral incisors, two crowns because she had already two metal ceramic crowns, and another veneers. This is the detail of the shoulder that I was doing 13 years ago with magnification. This is the delivery of the work. The patient was very pleased, but I had always a problem of some frenitus on the two crowns. Okay, I wasn't able, even grinding and grinding, to remove this frenitus. The patient has no discomfort, she was very pleased with the aesthetic result, and the case started his life. This is the 6-month control. The surgery was fine, not so much tissue rebound, a good maturation of the soft tissue. There was a good healing of this part, the healing is improved in the ears. This was not the wrong part. This is at 11 months. You see, at 11 months, we are going quite well, okay? Patient is happy, I'm happy. I did an aesthetic treatment, doing just, we can say, 6 teeth. 5 years. 5 years, the patient come back, complaining about a crack on the canine. Because I finished this case, at the beginning, doing canine guidance. Because, you know, in all the books of dentistry, they say to you that you have to do canine guidance. And instead, I learned at my expenses that not always you have to do canine guidance. In many cases, it's better to avoid it. But you know, experience is something that you can pay on your skin. So, I just cleaned the piece of veneer and I rebonded in position. But after a while, you see always a little stain. When you rebond veneers, the rebonding is successful from an adhesive point of view. But you have some staining after a bit of time. And at 5 years, if you see, do you remember the frenitus? I had a slight buccal movement of the two crowns. Because this kind of contact started to move something. Let's go on. 6 years and off. Crack of the other veneer, the lateral. Okay? Because what I did, when the canine chipped, I removed the canine guidance and probably I left some too steep guidance on the lateral. And so the patient chipped the lateral. What I did the same. I took the veneers, I cleaned and I rebonded the piece in position. But even here, you can see that at 9 years, you have a bit of staining in this area. So now at 9 years, we have the chipping of the canine in the middle and the chipping of the lateral. Both were rebonded and you see that the rebonding is successful. Here you can see how I grinded the basal surface in order to try to avoid this frenitus, but it was not possible because the problem in this patient is not the thickness of the crown, is that you increase the overbite value. And in this kind of patient, with time, I understood the pattern that they have, and this patient, if you increase the overbite, you will always pay the price. Soon or later. So, look here the canine, here on the right, how much is worn in the inner part, and what happens at this point? At this point happens that the load goes on the premolar, and I have a vertical crack on tooth 2.4. The tooth was so cracked, here is the buccal piece, that I did the post-extractive implants. 10 years, 2018. Patient has a swelling on the other side. Because of the same reason, look here at the canine, there is a flat area here, so there is no freedom for posterior teeth, and the buccal cusp of premolar started in this way to act as a guidance, laterality, and splitted. But fortunately, I was able to do an odontic treatment, and with the zirconia crown, I've been able to save this tooth. 11 years endorf. Fremitus, for 11 years, put a biomechanical stress on this teeth, and at the end, you pay the price with the fracture. Also because I did also a shoulder, also because I didn't analyze in a good way the ferrule that I had. I have so many reasons that we can stay on this case for all the night, so I want to go on. But honestly, now I have so much things to say, so much things that I see on this case, and I realized this thanks to observation of failures. And also thanks because I did photos from 2001. Because if you don't do photos, if you don't track your activity, when you have a problem, how can you understand what is the problem? At the beginning, I was doing photos because I wanted to do the show. But with the time, I realized that doing the photos is the only way to improve our dentistry. Now, for example, it's from a while that I do photos to all cases, not the nice one. Because the disease of our work is that, and I did the same at the beginning, is that we do photos at the nice case. You see the case that you think that will be a great case to post on Facebook, to bring at the Congress, and you don't do photos at all the other. Instead, more photos you do, more experience with the time you will gain. Now I do photos at all my patients. I do photos in the first consultation because I don't know who is the failure and when. So I try to make photos as much as possible. This patient broke this her teeth. Now I know that I was wrong, that I did a mistake, that canine guidance was not correct, that the overbite value were not correct. And I would like to say that at this point I'd been able to say to her, look, it was wrong and we have to change your occlusion, because with another kind of occlusion this will work better. But the patient got divorced and now she has zero money, because her husband now is with a 25 years old lady. And so what I did with €0, I just removed the fiber post that in these situations, in my experience, perform not so well. I did two metal posts and I rebonded the old crowns. And now they are still there. I saw her 2 months ago and they are performing well. But I know that sooner or later she will come back. Wait that I change the slide. Let's see another case. 14 years ago, 2006. Let me see. Okay, we are 200. It's a nice number, 202. I see that the other times there were a lot of comments about the technical aspect of vertical prep. Now you are just looking, saying, whoa, there is nothing to ask. Let's go on. 2006, 14 years ago. This is Patrizia. Wait. This is Patrizia. Here I did so many mistakes, not only from a technical point of view. I have also been unlucky, honestly. But I did here, even if this is not the topic, if you want, we can talk about this in another session also, because till we have this lockdown and I'm closed here, we have a lot of time to talk. I did a lot of mistakes in communication because I was young and I was overconfident. She came to me in 2006. I was already using microscope at that time. My hand was already quite good. So what I did? I looked at these central incisors, 7 millimeters, and immediately say, whoa. A central incisor has to be 10 millimeters. So if I do a crown lengthening, I will recover. Also on the teeth, on the upper right, I will recover a lot of sound dental structure, and I will keep everything without doing extractions. So this was my idea in my mind, okay? So veneers on a bridge, doing crown lengthening on from second premolar to lateral. Some veneers in the anterior area, a crown on the left canine, and an implant in the left area because she was missing 2.4. Okay, so I did my surgery. I have the photo of the isolation of the, this is the lateral, this is the 1.2, and this is the premolar. I did my fiber post under magnification, under microscope, under rubber dam. This is the situation that I had after a while, after the healing of the soft tissue. You see here that I have recovered a lot of structure. I have a good maturation here of the soft tissue. I did the preparation for the veneers in the anterior area. This is 14 years ago. I am proud about it. Cementation on the rubber dam of these veneers. And this is the finished case. I know it's not so good, but you have to think 14 years ago. I was 26, okay? I was very, very busy at that time. 4 years later, the premolar, the one with two fiber posts, I don't know if I had the decementation of the fiber post and after a fracture. I think it's more easy this. But I had the fracture of the premolar. The patient, like in many cases, didn't come to the office. And come to the office after she broke also the canine and the lateral. So when she arrived to my office, everything was destroyed in that area. I removed this teeth, and in the intermediate, I put some implants, so in native bone, okay, not post-extracted, because I had 2, 3, and 5, and I used 6, 4, and 2. Only on the lateral I did the post-extracted implant. You can see here the veneer that had a small crack when I did the cementation, that even here, after 4 years, start to have some staining. I did my implants, I developed the ovoid, I had a bit of resorption after the extraction, and so I ended up with slightly bulky crowns. But fortunately, this was the smile line of the patient, so this was not so much a problem. After 2 years, this is a patient, honestly, with so many health problems. She suffers from everything, from cancer, infective problems. She is a very unlucky patient, okay? And she's unlucky also on teeth. In 2012, I started to have a problem of perimplantitis, and despite the oral agentation and despite everything, after 6 months, she had immediately a deep probing of these lower incisors. I tried, hoping it was an endoperior lesion, to do endodontic treatment, but there was nothing to do. And this is after 3 years later. After 3 years, she had the complete perimplantitis of this teeth and the bridge was moving, okay? Here on the lower, we are still with the provisional. Because the patient told me that she had no more trust in dentistry, and this is not so easy to listen to these things when you think that you do a good dentistry. And so after 3 years, we are still with the provisional. And you will see that she was right. So, 2015, we are at 9 years of follow-up. And this is 2017. 2017, she lost completely the implants, but not the post-extractive one. This is the craziness of nature. She had her health situation got much worse, and she had periodontal problems on all her teeth at this moment. Look here the X-ray. K9 was moving, mobility class 3. I had just these two implants. She had the mobility also on the lower incisors. With the time, she did endodontic treatment because of sensitivity also. And this is Patrizia after 13 years after the first treatment. She has lost in 2019 even the other implants where I put the ball to help some retention of the upper mobile prosthesis. She has lost for mobility all the four incisors. And at the beginning of this month, just before closing for the lockdown here in Italy, I extracted also two, 3.5. And 3.4 is starting to move. We have also to learn to be humble. There are some unlucky patients that honestly, they will fail. Honestly. The problem is the expectations. Because when you have a patient unlucky, at the beginning, he/she says that he's unlucky, but you, in your overconfidence, says that your work will last forever, maybe. This was my biggest mistake in this case. Let's see another patient with a worn dentition. Any comment? No, you are just enjoying my shit. Okay. Now we have arrived to 230. It's a pleasure, guys. Another patient with worn dentition. Look here, 2003-2004. I was 24 years old, okay? I was the so-called the young gun with so enthusiasm in dentistry. Charged from courses and congresses. This is the preoperative. There was so many things to do in the mouth of this girl. There was decay, you can see in the photo on the upper arch, but see that 17 years ago, at 24 years old, the documentation that I was doing, okay, the photos are not wonderful photos, but you can track everything that you have done. You can recollect all the mistakes that you have done in 20 years. How you can do this without having photos? This is the main message also that I want to give you. Accept failures and document your cases, but not for show up. This is also a nice part, but it's not the most important for your real clinical life. This is the X-ray. I did the endodontic treatment of the upper molar. I did the retreatment of the lower one. I did the retreatment of the premolar on the left for that lesion, but let's focus on the treatment plan for the worn dentition. I raised the vertical dimension of occlusion. Okay, you can see here I did this doing some provisional crown. I did the face bow. I raised on the articulator. I waxed the case in the lab, and I did provisional crown for the molar at increased the vertical dimension of occlusion to only additional only on premolar. And they did the direct restoration on the lower incisors and on the upper incisor. This was the test drive. I was 24 years old, obviously, and I was taught from my prosthetic course that I have to test for at least 6 months if everything was fine or not with the occlusion that I have created in this patient. So I did this composite. I did the cementation of the overlay. I did the direct restoration on the lower incisors. Ah, we have Fulvio. Ciao, Fulvio. Anche not dove c'è un caso tuo, però non è stasera. Ok. I commenti a me stanno arrivando. Ok. I was looking if there were some comments. Okay. I did this on the upper. I did the direct restoration. I was working from not so many times, so composite were not so nice, obviously. But the, honestly, this was just the drive. It was something like a mock-up. So I was not so much concerned also in doing a very beautiful work, okay? This was just a test drive. After 6 months, everything was fine. I did the 6 veneers for the upper. For economical reasons, I left the direct restoration on the lower and I just did veneers in ceramic on K9 because I was looking for the K9 guidance. Alexander is asking me, but why I don't see the comments here? Let me check. Oh well, Daniele has forwarded me the question. Alexander is asking me, what is the reason of the failure of the previous case, no? Of Patrizia. Allora, honestly, on the bridge, on the upper, this was a mistake of mine. Okay? No doubt because I had this kind of failure much more times. When you work in teeth with scarce ferrule, with a sort of old, we can say, dentin with the fiber post, I had after 4 or 5 years a good, we can say, rate of decementation or complications, especially when you work with horizontal preparation, because you are starting to work with a compromised tooth, so we have already biomechanical problems, and during horizontal preparation you remove much for dental structure, you put, doing the design of a shoulder, a snap point where all the load and the stress is charged, fiber post loaded after a lot of time tend to weaken the adhesion. There is something like, I can say, micro-infiltration. We can say you have the loose of the adhesion and with the stiffening starts to move. And at the end, you have or a decementation and you find a lot of decay, or you have a fracture because this post starts to move. Who say that the fiber post is a good solution, for example, because the failure is a good one? Is a fraud because in many cases, because Because otherwise I lose the connection with ideas. Because in many cases, when you recognize the failure, sometimes you are lucky and you have just the possibility to re-put the crown with the fiber post in position. But in many cases, if you have some undercuts, the patient will come back after the roots is completely decayed. This is what happened to me in most of the situation with failure with fiber post. And this of Patrizia was one of the cases. The problem on the other teeth, honestly, I did veneers on the other teeth, so the complication here was not so much a complication of mine. The problem was that I did the work on this teeth and the teeth failed, okay? Allora, honestly, Patrizia was not so constant in oral hygiene recalls. But the oral hygiene was not so bad, honestly. I think that there is a connection much more stronger than we realize between health and periodontal problems. This is something that I see also sometimes in other kind of patient with some problems. There is a much more strong connection in some patient between health and periodontal problems. The problem is that we are not able to sometimes to realize this. We jump too much easy to the treatment plan. With the time, this is one of the few advantages of the failure experience, you start to develop something like a sixth sense, okay? But honestly, there is a connection much more stronger between health problems and periodontal problems, and we have not so many ways to understand this today. Another colleague asked me, I don't understand because I don't see the comment, but I just see how many people is connected. However, I have Daniele that is forwarding me the comments. In this case, yes. Another colleague asked me how much time I tested the mockup. I tested the mockup 6 months. Okay? The mockup, look here, for example. The mockup test was, we can say, good. But look here, the incisal, the margin of the lower incisors after 6 months. And it was composite on composite, okay? Not composite on ceramic. After 6 months, you can see that there is already a bit of wear, okay? And I will pay the price. If you do an occlusion, that it is not the occlusion that this kind of patient wants. Because another overlooked aspect that I have discovered with the time is the is a more, much, much more longer topic, but just to say, try to note that when you have patients with worn dentition, they have a very flat occlusal plane, okay? These patients have a very gliding and horizontal chewing pattern. And if they have also some parafunction, these patients are patients that does not accept any kind of incisal and canine guidance. This is patient that have to be restored in a different way, okay? In this patient, I try to copy the old wear facets, for example, and I've seen that it is much more successful approach. But we go on. So I did this cementation. This is the case after 3 years. Okay, at 3 years, 2004 delivery, 2007, 3 years, everything was good. Patient was very pleased. She was sending me photos by mail. Now, again, when complication arrive, 2, 3, 5, after 5, 6 years, in this case, at 7 years, the canine guidance was not accepted by this patient. Just read the comment. The problem is, guys, that I cannot read the comment, otherwise I lose. Wait, to look here, I lost the connection of the camera. Wait for a minute. Wait for a minute, I have to connect again the iPhone. Meanwhile, I try to speak. This patient I did an endodontic, I did a canine guidance. Wait, I find the application. Okay. I did the canine guidance, and this was not accepted by his pattern of mastication, of chewing. Okay. Unfortunately, if I open my messages, I have no possibility, so we have to be short because I just see the notification. Okay. Do you see me back? Yes, okay. 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 So this is the close up of the canine. You can see that the veneers has fractured completely. And I did a new one. This time not in pespatic, but I tried with something that was much more tough, and it was lithium disilicate. 8 years. The incisal guidance was not well tolerated by the patient, so the patient put a biomechanical stress over and over and over, and at the end she fractured the veneer. At the beginning I did the patch, like in the other case, but the discoloration after a while was not accepted by the patient, and they did a completely new veneer. This is 8 years of follow-up. This is the case at 12 years. I didn't see this patient after for 4 years because she went in the city. Wait, that I am also seeing the comments. Guys, but here on I wrote here, and I don't see the comments. Ah, no, here, yes. Where I wrote here, you can write here, so I see the comments here, because I cannot open on the iPhone. Okay, try to write what I wrote here now, in order that I can see. Okay, this is the case that I didn't see this patient for 4 years, and after I saw her again at 12 years, and she was experiencing some periodontal problems, but she was not living again in my town, in Syracuse. She was in Agrigento. It's not so far, but the road is so a mess that it's like living very far, very, very far. And in 2017, the fiber one again, now I say, in 2017, after 13 years, the patient called me back because she fractured the other incisors. But she fixed in the city where she's living now, okay? Allora, okay, about fiber post. Allora, fiber post. I have stopped doing fiber post, honestly. Because in my hands, and also in Pasquale's hands, and in many hands that I know, if they perform well, it's because you don't need a post in many cases, okay? Mute voice for comments. How? What I have to do? Mute the voice. Vabbè, let's go on. We have to manage better this program. What I was telling, I disconnected. I lost the point. I was talking about fiber post. Because in many cases, when they perform well, it's because you don't need them. It's like, how can I say? Everything is related to the biomechanics of the tooth. If the complex is suffering from tension forces or not. Now, if the tooth is quite tough, the tooth itself is able to withstand with the load, and you put the fiber post and it is just something in that area. But when you need really to load the area of the post, you need to be careful about how much stiff is the complex and how much real ferrule do you have. For example, for the ferrule, we know that the ferrule, the real one, is just on a vertical wall. So when you do a shoulder like this, for example, you have, for example, denting till this point, but this is not ferrule, okay? All this part, the inclined plane, is not ferrule. This is a part of the tooth that you are not using. The ferrule starts just from this point, okay? So if you have, for example, a chamfer on a shoulder, and you have just on this part, you have dentin, you are working already with 0.0 ferrule, okay? So you are already in troubles. The second point is that the complex, because adhesion on dentin is already a problem, and underload is a bigger problem, the stiffer is the complex, the better is. So, honestly, in very compromised cases, my feeling is that rigid post metal one correctly done, okay, correctly done, perform much more better than fiber post. This is my point, and this is my experience. Now, I show you another case. This is a story of two siblings, Mariano and Arianna. Mariano came in my office when I was very, very young. Parents were complaining about missing central incisors. You can see from this X-ray then he had two sovranumerary teeth. This is the small X-ray. Wait that I show better. Okay. So what I did, I used something like a palatal expansion, RP, with these two small arms. I did the flap together at this time with the Dr. Dario Di Paolo. In 2002, I was not able to do surgery. Extraction of supranumerary. Placed the bracket. Suture. Okay. Everything was fine. Teeth very easily came down after just 4 brackets and 2 for 4. And Mariano was fine. Okay. A colleague asked me about what is my vision about post and core. So in this moment, honestly, the most important thing is to save dental structure. So, when I deal with cases where nobody before me has put hands, in 90% of cases, doing minimal endodontic access cavities, doing vertical preparation, I'm able to work without any kind of post, okay? Because I save dental structure. The amount of dental structure is of paramount importance in the future outcome of the tooth restorative complex, okay? When you deal with very compromised cases, however, and I need the post, I always move to stiff post, okay? After is a matter of personal preferences, if you want to use titanium or you can use brass, for example. In some cases, compromised cases where I expect also a huge load, I go back to the old cast post, okay? I take the impression, I do the cast post in the lab and I do the cementation. Now I would like to introduce you the sister of Mariano, Arianna. Arianna, still nowadays, is a pain of my life. It's 16 years that I'm trying to get free of these problems. Arianna had a very similar problems. Parents are complaining about missing central incisors. Okay, let me have a look. About missing central incisors. This is the X-ray. Let me see. Okay, you see. You see that we have here a situation that it is worse than the situation of his brother, because we have more than one supranumerary. Look here. In this case, we have 3. The problem was that at that time, I did the surgery in this case, I was not able to locate the third one. Because the third one, I realized this after years when I bought a CBCT and I was also much more skilled, was placed behind the central incisors. It was close to the roots, very high in the palate, perfectly behind the central incisors. So even, and it was very deep, so even with a palatal flap, you have to destroy everything to arrive there. So honestly, it was something that I was not able to manage at the time, okay? I did the same treatment of Mariano and I started to pull these two teeth, but there was no way about the tooth 1.1. 2.1 erupted early. Instead, the 1.1 was locked in position. After 2 years of traction, Arianna was very tired, her parents too. I removed the appliance to give some rest and to hope. And the tooth erupted with no traction after 3 years alone. I was feeling so lucky at that time. So, here I am highlighting the third sovranumerary teeth. In order that here on this X-ray you can see, you can understand better where the sovranumerary tooth is. So this was the situation in 2011. I was thinking, easy peasy, we can say, no? Easy job, just put some brackets and do an easy alignment. But I placed the appliance, and after a while, this tooth stopped to move. I changed the wires, putting bigger wires, smaller wires, I tried anything, nothing. I was sure at the time that the reason was that fucked sovranumerary tooth, that was locking the movement of the tooth. So I did a sort of window, you know, like sinus lift. I did a window between the center incisors, I sectioned the sovranumerary, and I was able, cutting in many pieces, like you do in impacted canines on palate, I was able to remove this. You can see here the X-ray after the surgery, that there is no trauma to the, with the bar to the roots of this teeth. I go again with the traction, nothing. Okay? I tractioned from May to December for 7 months. And there was zero movement on this tooth. It was completely ankylosite. You can see here, even the torque was not correct, but there was no possibility to move, and the other teeth were starting to go up, and I was starting to have an open bite. So I was forced to stop my orthodontic treatment. So this is the situation in January 2013. I removed the appliance and I decided to do, because also of this palatal inclination, an additional veneer. I was lucky because despite Arianna was a teenager, the smile line was quite low. Otherwise, this would have been very, very problematic cases. This was the situation. This is the veneer made by Emanuele Tarasch. Now it's 13 years that we work together, that he deal with me. This is the veneer in position. And this is the finished case, you see, with the smile of Arianna. I was lucky because she has a low smile line. So the case was quite acceptable. 4 years and all later. Arianna, I didn't see Arianna for many years. I was thinking that I was free of these damned incisors, and she came back with this pink area. And you know what pink spots are before doing an X-ray. They are resorption. This is the other view. You see how good is the veneer instead, after 4 years and off. Look here, this is the resorption of these incisors. Arianna is in his, in her 20s, so I don't want to extract this tooth, also because I have already been unlucky with that, so I don't want to. So I do a small flap. I put some Geristor, is a glassionomer material that it is quite good in this kind of situation. I did this big restoration, but I have no keratinized tissue. Arianna has never been so good also in oral hygiene. She forgets that the area, the gingiva in that area is higher, and she doesn't brush in that area. So this is the situation of the soft tissue. The good thing is that I've saved the tooth and that she has a slow smile line. 2 years later, this tooth started to move. This tooth had a bit of extrusion. Okay, Arianna came back to my office saying that the tooth was longer than the other one. So I have fought with this tooth without being able to move, and after 7 years, it started to move. Okay? So what I did, I just shortened the veneer. In September 2019, again, the tooth moved a bit. I shortened again the incisal margin. The good things of the extrusion is that automatically you improve the soft tissue. So at this point, I hope that it will extrude much more so that doing an implant, it will be easier. I improved a bit the Geristol. That Geristol, from an aesthetic point of view, is not so nice. I sandblasted, I worked with a bar and I put some composite on the top. And I shortened again. I've shared with you these cases. These are all cases with the you have seen long-term follow-up, okay? The first one was 14 years, after 15 years, 13 years, Arianna is something like 16 years. And you have seen that failures are something that arise, especially in complex cases, after more than 5-6 years. So you have to wait to understand, but you have to document before, if you want to understand what works and what doesn't work. Because the problem is that nowadays we focus so much on buying equipment. We focus so much on doing courses, on the technical aspects of a lot of things, okay? But the reality is that even if you can buy equipment, even if you can acquire knowledge, there is something nobody talked to you about. And it is that you have to develop the correct attitude. You have to learn to accept your failures and you have to learn to rise. Fall and rise. This is the key. Because it's not so much how hard you hit, it's about how hard you can get hit and keep going on. Just a small story about me. As you know, I started doing photos in 2001 when I bought my first camera. Talking to a congress was almost reserved to people connected with scientific academies or brands at that time, even today. And you have to know that I live in the small island in the bottom of the screen in Sicily. And from a scientific point of view, Italy is like split in half. Just to make you understand, the most important prosthodontic association in Italy has 59 active members. 55 are located in the north of Italy. And if you want to become a member, you have to be introduced by 2 active members. And you can immediately recognize that doing this when everybody, 55 on 59, are on the north of Italy, you have already a geographical wall that you have to go on. That was no Facebook at that time, just a small Italian dental forum. It was named Odontoline. I posted there for 8 years. Before receiving my first invitation to lecture in 2009. Okay? 8 years doing everyday photos, like we've seen today, without never being able to show. You can think that at that period, I was thinking that I was unsuccessful. Okay? That period was unsuccessful. But instead, I realize now that period probably has been the most important one. Because I learned many things. I learned persistence.
Now, I know what you're thinking. How the heck does a 52-year-old, over-the-hill, milkshake machine salesman build a fast food empire with 1,600 restaurants in 50 states, 5 foreign countries, with an annual revenue of in the neighborhood of $700 million? One word. Persistence. Nothing in this world can take the place of good old persistence. Talent won't. Nothing's more common than unsuccessful men with talent. Genius won't. Unrecognized genius is practically a cliché. Education won't. Why, the world is full of educated fools. Persistence and determination alone are all powerful.
But not only persistence. I learned two other big things. I learned to enjoy the path. Honestly, doing photos, looking at how I was improving in dentistry, I started to understand that the goal is just something that we have to put in our mind to give a direction. But the real pleasure is in the path. And this is one of the biggest things that I believe today. It's not important where you are, but it's important the path that you do. You have to enjoy the path. If you do the path just looking at the goal, if the goal is far, if you are not able to reach the goal, you will suffer from delusion so much. You have to learn to enjoy the path. You need time, but it's something that changes your life because you are always satisfied with what you do. And I learned another things. I learned that doing all this photography, the value of feedback, because I started to experience problems after 8 years, but I had the possibility to look back at my cases. And I saw that I had failures in many recurring patterns, and I've been able to recognize these patterns because I had photos. Not photos to show up, not photos of beautiful cases, but these were the most useful photos that I had in my life. After, in 2014, I founded with Pasquale Venuti Tomorrow Tut. And everything, and you know where we are now. We have been able to grow a successful group. Now we are 63,000 of members. We are doing courses and congresses almost everywhere. Unless now that I am like this. In these 5 years, I've pushed much, much more. But it's thanks to you that we are in these groups that I've been able to do this. Because you have given me the force and motivation, believing in this group, believing in this project. And it changed not only my dentistry. This changed your life in general. Because when you focus so much on something, you start to develop willpower. I will give you another example with a friend of mine. And willpower follows the rules of communicating bestness. If you learn to be very persistent in something in your life, in your work, you will discover, and this is proved by a lot of psychological studies also, you will discover that even in other areas of your life, you will improve. 11 years ago, I knew Daniele Bordonale. He was a dentist, without clear ideas, we can say. But he had passion in his eyes. I recognized it. I really recognize. I recognize when I see people with passion, recognize it. I pushed Daniele on the road of good quality dentistry because I love people around me to improve. This is something that I really enjoy, honestly. I pushed him and Daniele, honestly, today, just from a while, became a great dentist, honestly. I have nothing to teach to him, nothing. I am just sometimes a good friend. And his persistence brought him to a willpower that after a while started to improve other areas of his life. Daniele has been always very fat. It was more than 100 kilos, 105. And without the help of anybody, he has been able, alone, with this willpower, to arrive to 74, losing 31 kilos. Okay? And this is another goal obtained by the path that he has followed in these years. I don't think that I have special talent. I am persistent, of course. Daniele says that I have a gift. And I hope that it is true, because it should be a great one. Daniele says that I have the gift that I'm able to push people around me to give their best. Also, Emanuele Tarascio, my technician, did something similar. When I knew him 10 years ago, he was thinking that he was arrived, okay? And they pushed him, showing him a so long road. And I hope that I have this sort of gift that Daniele thinks. But I realized with the time that I'm not able to help everybody. Not everybody. I can help people that, like Daniele, has passion in his life. I just use the metaphor of sports, just to understand, okay? If you feel that you can do more, if you don't want to live your unfulfilled potential in your life, if you feel some emotion when you look at this kind of movies, this kind of sports, boys, if you are here, instead of being on Netflix looking at football or something else, a movie, it's because you are motivated. Honestly, you that follow this group, you deserve more, and you can obtain more. Sometimes you just need a small push, but you definitely can have more. You need nothing in your life to add more. And this is a great period, under certain point of views. You know, all the Europe is paralyzed by this COVID-19, by this virus. We will face a huge change in our life. I am locked in my house from 17 days now. We are fined now 3,000 euro if you have run outside. Something like running now is completely illegal. Having a walk in the historical center is something that you can do. So, but this is not just me in Italy. Most of Europe is in the same way, and probably a big part of the world will have to deal with this kind of problem. We will have to face a lot of changes. So this is one of the last moments that we have to understand what can we do and to improve our service. This is in this moment the situation that we have. In this moment you see that in Italy, China has started with the problem of the coronavirus. But after a while, we did, like in a car race, you know, Ferrari, we have done a good work. And now we've been able, not only despite being a very small country in comparison to China, to reach China, but after a while we've been able to go much over China, both with diseases and now with deaths. In this moment, we have arrived to 75,000 of diseases and something like 8,000 of death. This is the situation that we have now in Italy. And you have to know that we in the south are in a worse situation just because of one reason. We have not so much numbers in this moment, but you have to think that in my city, 150,000 people, the intensive care unit has something like 18 places, okay? 18. 1, 8. So try to think if 1,000 people would be in need of an hospital, okay? But despite of this, I don't complain, because complaining is useless. If you complain, your mind will focus on problems. Instead, it's much more useful to focus yourself on solutions. Probably most of you will be locked in your house. To be locked in your house is a different experience, of course, but honestly, there is a great thing. How many times we have not been able to do something because we have no time? Because you was a slave of your old habits, okay? Now you will face a period where all your old habits will be broken. Now is the time that you can build new good habits. And probably you will need good habits in the period that we will face, because the problem, in my opinion, is not the coronavirus, honestly. 99% of the population will survive to this, more. The problem will be the fear that people will have after this, and the changes that we will have from a political and social. Everything will change. And we have to be with a strong positive attitude in order to go out from this stronger than before. This is the moment that will divide who will win and who will lose. Just to understand, in these 17 years, I didn't watch TV. I am in love with Chinese, also because I found that this is the biggest gym for the head, because we have to train memory. Thanks, Mohammed. But honestly, I want you to perform better. I really desire that I have the gift that Daniele says that I have. In 17 days, I wrote around 10,000 Chinese characters. I did 120 Chinese lessons online. I did 200 pages of note. I am quite addicted to sport, okay? I love weightlifting, for example. Wait. I found new ways of training. I know that it is not the same to lift weights, but the problem is not what you do, it's in your mind. Because if you give up, there's no way back. You have always to find solutions. And even if the solution is not the best one, it's always a solution. I'm doing my final keynote on complex cases, where I will explain my view on a lot of cases, and I've been able to do 700 slides in 17 days. I had a lot of ideas in my mind about complex cases, but never had the time to do something like this. I have spent in 17 days more times that I usually spend with my son in 1 year. Usually being busy. I just see my son after dinner, and after a while he goes to sleep. Now I'm living a lot of time with him, and it is another huge experience. You see, there's nothing all bad. There is always something good. It's like the yin and yang of the Chinese. Look, good and evil are always connected. And you have to look at what you can get. Honestly, I was talking with Daniele. I see a lot of positive things for our offices. Not by 6 months. By 6 months, we have to do something like this. And we are ready to do this. But I see great opportunities for the next future. Because if you start to think what people want after this period, you can start to win even for your future life. I've been banned to go in the gym, and I started running. I hate running. After a while, they told that running is illegal. Okay. And you know what they did? I called Daniele. Daniele loves running. And they told him, Daniele, you know what we do now? Let's do a call in the morning. You in your house, me in my building, and we run on the stairs. I look on the web on some skyscrapers in the world, look how many floors they have, and we do up and down on the stairs, copying with this. This is the Istanbul Sapphire that I did yesterday, and it was 66 floors, okay? Then Daniele today did 77, so tomorrow I have to do 8, yeah? Now, this is me running on the shoes. We have always loved to say that tomorrow Tut is the other voice of dentistry. Because we talk about different things. We talk about non-aligning, injection molding, vertical prep in a different way, different vision on occlusion. I have a completely different vision about what malocclusion and good occlusion is. We have a lot of different vision in many things. We have definitely the other voice of dentistry. But now, in this period, I hope that we can help you become also the inner voice of your improvement. I want to close with these lines by Kipling. You know, if... Because there is a part that it is very keen with this period.
Losing theirs and blaming it on you. If you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too. If you can wait and not be tired by waiting, or being lied about, don't deal in lies. Or being hated, don't give way to hating, and yet don't look too good, nor talk too wise. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thoughts your aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat those two imposters just the same. Remember. If you can bear to hear the truth you've spoken, twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools, or watch the things you gave your life to broken, and stoop and build them up with worn-out tools. If you can make one heap of all your winnings, and risk it on one turn of pitch and toss, and lose and start again at your beginnings, and never breathe a word about your loss. If you can force your heart and nerve and sinew to serve your turn long after they are gone, and so hold on when there is nothing in you except the will which says to them, hold on. Talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings, nor lose the common touch. If neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you, but are none too much. If you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth distance run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it. And, which is more, you'll be a man, my son.
Thank you for your attention, guys. It has been a pleasure to stay with you. But, few minutes more. What's coming up in the next weeks? Because, you know, I'm still here. So, this is some Chinese, okay. But honestly, I'm getting a bit tired. Also because I've already finished one block and two pens, and I have nowhere to buy other pens, so I have to be careful. I have a lot of many things in my mind, and now I have the time to think about them. Okay, so let's choose a topic that you want to talk with me. Write in the comments, and I will look at it. We can talk about everything that you want. We can talk about failures again, because I have the cases. We can talk more about dentistry. We can talk about the science behind habits. We can talk more about the culture behind failures. We can talk about complex cases, for example. We can talk about occlusion. We can have a small talk about the topic that you want. I will enjoy to do something and to keep my mind always on. Also because, you know, the other nice things of doing this kind of working, writing, is that more you write and more you find ideas and your mind goes on. So, guys, hold on. It has been a pleasure. This was really the last one. Okay. As usual, if you want, you have bigger and more content also on our educational channel. Okay. We go in much bigger detail about every single detail of our techniques. We have videos, we have procedures, so we have something more complete about our approach, and we are every month upload this. And in this month, also because my mind is always running, I think that I will move the format in a different way, but just wait some weeks to know what I have in mind. So thank you, guys. I switch off the keynote. I will go back to read the comments and then we start to answer after a while. Hold on.